A lot of people say that nature should be left alone. They think humans can only cause problems when we meddle in the natural order of things. Do you agree? How do you feel then about science doing exactly the opposite of that sometimes? Most of the time, it's part of research to better understand how genes work so that we can make human lives better and maybe even cure diseases. But sometimes that's not always the case. Let's find out if you agree with all of that. My name is Danny Burke, and this is the top 10 scary mutant animals created by science. Starting off at number 10, now we have the Vacanti Mouse. There's no easy way to say this. The Vacanti Mouse was a mouse with a human ear on its back. Well, not technically. The ear mouse was created by Charles Vacanti and his colleagues at the University of Massachusetts in 1997. The ear on its back was actually an ear-shaped piece of cartilage grown by seeding cow cartilage cells into a biodegradable ear-shaped mold that was then implanted underneath the mouse's skin. But yeah, it's an ear, basically. So what was the point of all of this? Well, when the picture started circulating around the internet in the late 1990s, many people used it in protests against genetic engineering. However, no genetic manipulation was actually performed here. The whole point was to show that transplantation of fabricated cartilage into humans is possible. We have the Vacanti mouse to thank for that, even if it does look very weird. Next up at number 9 now, we have the see-through frog. I love this one. In 2007, Japanese researchers succeeded in producing see-through frogs. The reason is that they didn't have to kill and dissect them anymore in order to study their organs, blood vessels, and eggs. How amazing is that? In modern times, dissections have become increasingly controversial. Many animal rights activists have called for more humane methods of studying frogs without having to perform dissections. Lead researcher Masayuki Sumida said, "You can watch organs of the same frog over its entire life as you don't have to dissect it." The researcher can also observe how toxins affect bones, livers, and other organs at lower costs. These frogs were created from rare mutants of the natural Japanese brown frog. They bred pale frogs together until the offspring were completely translucent. At the time, the researchers also said they could inject the frogs with an illuminating protein that would cause parts of the frog to glow when cancer starts. Imagine if they did that with humans. Interesting, but perhaps a little bit creepy. Moving on to number 8 now, we have Dolly the Sheep. Some of you may have heard of this one before. Dolly was a sheep. She was also the first mammal to be cloned from an adult cell. She was born in Scotland after scientists from the University of Edinburgh did years of research and failed attempts. She was created using the technique of somatic cell nuclear transfer, where the cell's nucleus from an adult cell is transferred into an unfertilized egg cell that's had its nucleus removed. The cell is then stimulated to develop by an electric shock. The cell was then implanted into a surrogate mother and was eventually born into a healthy, normal-looking. The cell was then implanted into a surrogate mother and eventually became a healthy, normal-looking sheep called Dolly. It's a risky procedure and often results in stillborns or calves that last just a few days or weeks. However, Dolly was stable. The scientists waited almost 7 months to announce her to the world, but when they did, the news was everywhere. Many people called it the breakthrough of the year. This cloning paved the way for other large animal clones such as pigs, deer, horses, and bulls. In January 2018, scientists even successfully cloned macaque monkeys, the first primates ever cloned. Is human cloning around the corner? Next up at number 7 now, we have the Glo Fish. These are fish that glow in the dark. They aren't locked away in some lab away from the public eye. You can buy them. They are on the market. They are 100% for sale. In 1999, scientists in Singapore took the glowing gene of a jellyfish and inserted it into the embryo of an Indian zebrafish. The result? Was glowfish. They glow in both natural and ultraviolet light. This wasn't the ultimate goal for the scientists. They actually wanted to develop a fish that could detect water pollution by glowing in the presence of environmental toxins. They were then approached by Yorktown Technologies, who bought the right to sell the fish worldwide. They are sold in bright red, green, orange, yellow, blue, and purple fluorescent colors. Their names include electric green, moonrise pink, cosmic blue, and galactic purple. The FDA approved them for sale in the US once they assessed that they were not going to end up in the food chain. But still, if you see one, maybe don't eat it. That's just my advice for today. Next up at number 6 now, we have Ruppy. In 2009, scientists at Seoul National University created the world's first transgenic dog. Her name was Ruppy, and she glowed under ultraviolet light. Of course, the gene to glow in UV doesn't naturally occur in dogs. They got the gene from sea anemones. Ruby was created by cloning fibroblast cells that express a red fluorescent gene produced by the sea anemones. It was hoped that transgenic dogs like Ruppy would become effective stand-ins for the study study of human diseases. Professor Lee Byung-chun led the research team and said, "What's significant in this work is not the dogs expressing red colors, but that we planted genes into them." Of course, he can say that, but the media and the world became obsessed with the idea of a dog that glowed when you shone a UV light on it. Other scientists criticized the process, saying transgenesis is laborious, expensive, and slow. Moving on to number 5 now, we have the sudden death mosquitoes. That's the name that's been given to these mosquitoes because essentially scientists have engineered them to possibly bring an end to their own species. Sounds crazy? This is how it works. They genetically modified male mosquitoes with lethal genes. Once released, the males mate with the females in the wild and release these lethal genes, which kills them or kills the offspring before they can develop into adulthood. If successful, techniques like this could wipe out huge swathes of mosquito populations around the world or even bring them to extinction. The result isn't just because mosquitoes are annoying, it's to stop them from spreading the likes of dengue fever, which has no known cure and has put nearly half of the world's population at risk of infection. Of course, this is good news for humans. 2.3 million infections and 25,000 deaths could be prevented every single year. However, as bad as they are, some people are questioning whether humans have the right to intentionally kill off mosquitoes, an entire species. What do you guys think? Coming at number 4 now, we have the fast-growing salmon. In 2015, America's FDA approved Aqua Advantage salmon for human consumption. These are Atlantic salmon with an added gene which allows them to grow all year round instead of only during spring and summer. The intention has been to increase the speed at which the fish grows without affecting its ultimate size or other qualities. These fish can now reach their market size in 16 to 18 months instead of the usual 3 years. Despite the approval by the FDA and other governments around the world, it's unlikely that you'll be finding these special salmon everywhere. Back when they were approved, there was just 2 land-based facilities that were allowed to grow the fish. One day though, they could become the norm. Next up at number 3 now, we have the Enviropig, a name that I absolutely love. In 2010, researchers at the University of Guelph created genetically engineered pigs dubbed the Enviropig. Now on the surface, they look just like normal pigs, but it's not about the outside, it's about what's going on inside them. You see, normal pigs produce a lot of phosphorus in their urine and feces. That then finds its way into lakes, rivers, and oceans, causing algae blooms. The outburst of algae rapidly depletes the water's oxygen levels, creating vast dead zones that kill fish and other aquatic life. Not good. Pigs are often blamed for contributing to exactly this. These specially engineered Enviropigs produce up to 65% less phosphorus in their urine and feces. This would make things better for the environment, but also for farmers. You see, many farmers had to abide by strict laws that allow no farms to release nitrogen or phosphorus runoffs. They usually have to store all the waste and wait for it to be treated and recycled as fertilizer. This is all just added costs for farmers. It's hoped that the Enviropigs could change all that and do some good for the environment at the same time. Moving on to number 2 now, we have the sterile pink bollworm. Pink bollworms are a nightmare for cotton farmers. Every year they destroy cotton crops around the world. It got so bad that the US Department of Agriculture began tests to see if they could stop the worms in their tracks. They began growing a lot of pink bollworms in laboratories. That might sound counterproductive if your aim is to reduce their numbers, but wait. The male bollworms had actually been genetically engineered to be totally sterile, meaning even if they mated with a female, no offspring would come about. The worms were then released back into the natural population where they competed with wild male bollworms for the females. Scientists hope that if enough of these sterile males mate with the females, the number of offspring would be greatly reduced, providing some relief for cotton farmers around the world. And finally, at number 1 now, we have the see-through goldfish. In 2009, Japanese researchers succeeded in creating a goldfish that was so translucent you can see its heart beating inside its body. The aim was to create a fish that could be studied without the need for a dissection, the same reason for the frogs that we talked about earlier. Yutaka Tamaru, a professor of the study, said, "You don't have to cut it open. You can see a tiny brain above the goldfish's black eyes." Scientists created the fish using selective breeding. They took 2 natural fish who had slightly paler skin than the rest and bred them together. They continued like this with the offspring until the skin became so pale it was see-through. The fish are expected to live up to 20 years. They can grow as long as 10 inches and weigh more than 6 pounds. That's much bigger than fish used in similar experiments. They hope that for the people studying these fish, they can now see their whole life cycle take place underneath their see-through skin without ever having to hurt them. Okay, that's all I've got. What did you think of the little mutants we talked about today? Some people argue that we shouldn't be messing with nature like this. Others welcome it, and we talked talked about ways in which they help or even save people's lives. It's an interesting discussion, and I look forward to hearing your thoughts in the comment section below. Thanks as always for watching. My name is Danny Burke, and I will see you all in the next video.